हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ स्टेबिलिटी। लेट मी राइट हियर स्टेबिलिटी। सी यस्टरडे वी हैड डिस्कशन अबाउट स्टेबिलिटी। एक्चुअली वी डिडंट हैड सो मच डिस्कशन अबाउट द स्टेबिलिटी, बट वी हैड एन इंट्रोडक्शन। व्हाट इज स्टेबिलिटी? इफ output voltage of a regulator, look at this, if output voltage of a regulator is changing with respect to something, right, we refer it as an stability. If output voltage is changing with respect to input voltage, for example like this, if VO is changing with respect to change in input voltage, let me write this change in as this, then it is called voltage stability. It is called voltage stability. But and I told you that yesterday, for any electronic circuit, temperature stability is the most important, is it? The stability of any electronic circuit is generally referred with the temperature, is it? How the circuit is stable with respect to temperature, is it? Here, how the regulator circuit is stable with respect to input voltage, is it? We have another parameter, that is IL, is it? How the output of regulator circuit is stable with respect to the load current, is it? So like this, we have three parameters. First one is IL. The second one we had is Vin, and third one is temperature, is it? That's what yesterday's discussion. Output voltage must be stable with respect to load current. Output voltage must be stable with respect to input voltage, and output voltage must be stable with respect to the temperature. Right? I told you yesterday that temperature is a universal parameter. Every electronic circuit has to be stable with reference to or with respect to the temperature, is it? It has to. So that's why stability of a circuit, it means it is a stability of a circuit with reference to the temperature always, is it? As we are in the second video lecture in this voltage regulators, we will start with the classification of regulators and all, right? Because the stability already we have discussed yesterday, and then we started this today as well. Let me, as a formal discussion or a formal conclusion of whatever we have studied, I will write stability factor as, look at here, stability factor is equals to, or give me notation as stability factor, or I will say it is a voltage stability factor, is it? Now it seems okay, voltage stability factor, that is SV. How output voltage is changing with respect to the change in input voltage, is it? So that's why this voltage stability factor should be as small as possible. It means output voltage should not change if I change input voltage. Practically, there must be very small change in output voltage if there is large change in input voltage, is it? This is what stability of output voltage with respect to the stability of input voltage, is it? We refer it as a stability factor or voltage stability factor. But actually, stability factor for any electronic circuit is what? How output voltage changes, look at this, delta VO, with reference to temperature. This is what actual stability factor for all electronic circuits, is it? Output voltage for any electronic circuit must be constant with respect to the temperature. But see, we have two parameters in case of regulators, is it? IL and VIN. So output voltage must be stable with respect to IL also, and output voltage must be stable with respect to VIN also, is it? And it has to stable with respect to temperature also, which is universal thing. So that's why we have defined this voltage stability factor as a change in output voltage with respect to change in input voltage, and the stability factor must be very small. So now let us stop this discussion about stability and move towards the classification. So let us start with classification of voltage regulators. So let me write it as classification. The title must be classification. Now the voltage regulators are classified generally into two groups, right? Or I can say two types. First type is series voltage regulator. I will write here series voltage regulator. And the second type is, it is obvious, series voltage regulator is the first type. So second type must be a shunt voltage regulator. Shunt voltage regulator. So shunt means it is a parallel. I hope you understand. Shunt means parallel. So series voltage regulator and parallel voltage regulator. That's what the rough two types of the voltage regulator. So in case of series voltage regulator, I can have transistor voltage regulators, I can have IC voltage regulators. So I can have different components by help of which I can build, I can design, I can analyze this voltage regulator, series voltage regulator especially. Again, in shunt regulators, I can build shunt regulators by using some Zener diodes, by using some transistors. Is it? So those are few components with the help of which I can design voltage shunt regulators. Is it? So we will start with most simplest type of regulator, which is Zener voltage regulator. Is it? The motto is behind starting with Zener shunt regulator is to tell you about the Zener diode, which is a new type of diode which is not aware for us right now. What we know about the diode is a simplest rectifier diode is known. The characteristics we have seen, how it operates, what's the working, even the construction also we have seen in the first chapter. Now we need to start with another type of diode, which is Zener diode. Is it? We will understand the Zener diode first, and then we will study how the Zener diode is working as a regulator. Is it? So instead of starting with series voltage regulator, let us start with shunt voltage regulator. Look at this. We'll start with shunt voltage regulators. So in shunt voltage regulators, the first type intentionally that I am considering is Zener shunt regulator. Is it? So if you are writing notes with me, you can write down a title as shunt voltage regulators. And under shunt voltage regulator, the first type that we are going to discuss is Zener shunt regulator. I'll write here Zener, Z-E-N-E-R, Zener. Zener shunt regulator. See, this is what the first type under shunt regulators. Is it? We will finish shunt regulator first, then we'll move towards series voltage regulators. Because the reason is there, the operation of shunt voltage regulators is not complex as such, is it? Or we can say it is easiest as I compare them with series voltage regulators. So shunt voltage regulators are quite easy to understand, quite easy to design as well. So that's why we are starting with shunt regulators, is it? So under the shunt regulator, the first type that we are going to start with is Zener shunt regulator. Right. So now let us start with Zener shunt regulator. Now, before starting with this Zener shunt regulator, we need to understand what is that word Zener. Yeah. Basically, it is a type of diode. Let me write it as Zener diode. Mm-hmm. Zener diode. So, in Zener shunt regulator, the major component which is used is Zener diode. So, let me draw the symbol of Zener diode as, look at this, Zener diode has symbol like this. look at this. This is what a rectifier diode symbol is it? Just modify it, and this will be your Zener diode, a symbol of Zener diode. Right. Now, what is the difference between the rectifier diode that we have studied and the Zener diode that we are supposed to study now? Yes, there is a small difference. Now, we will understand the difference of Zener diode and rectifier diode with the help of characteristics, is it? So, let us examine what are the characteristics, or let's draw the VI characteristics graph. First, we'll draw the VI characteristics graph of rectifier diode. Look at this. I will draw this here. We know that if I am drawing VI characteristics, what is there on x-axis and what is there on y-axis? On x-axis there is voltage and on y-axis there is current, is it? V versus I, that's why we refer it as an VI characteristics of a diode. So if it is a simple rectifier diode like this, if it is, then what we do, we draw a forward characteristic. So let us forward bias this diode. Look at this, this is anode and this is cathode. So anode has to be connected with positive terminal of the battery and cathode has to be connected with negative terminal of the battery. So I'm connecting it, and if I increase this voltage from 0, then 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like this I am going to increase this voltage linearly, and I will observe the current which is flowing through this diode. Look at it, this current I supposed to observe, this is I, look at, and the voltage across the diode, that's what I supposed to observe. So voltage across the diode and current flowing through the diode, that's what I need to observe by changing the biasing voltage. This voltage I will refer it as an biasing voltage, is it? If you want large diagram, then let me draw it here. This is voltage across the diode that I have applied, positive, negative terminal of the battery, and then I will measure this voltage across diode, and then I will measure the current which is flowing through the diode. That's what it is. This is I and this is V. So let us start increasing this voltage. Is it? Things are known. I know that we have studied this in your first year also, and the diode study was there in your 11 and 12 physics also, is it? So let us start with increasing this voltage VB from 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 and so on. So what I will observe, that if I increase this up to certain point, there is no current through the diode, and at a certain point diode will start conducting, is it? So if this diode is made up of silicon material, then this voltage is 0.7 roughly. At actually it is 0.69. I am considering a rough figure as 0.7. So at 0.7 the diode will start conducting, and this is what practical characteristics I have drawn. So practically diode will start conducting at 0.7, and I am getting that kind of graph when the diode is forward biased. Now, what will happen when diode is reverse bias? Look at this, the same diode is in reverse bias now. See, we are not going to discuss more on the characteristics because we have studied those diode characteristics so many times, is it? So now, let us reverse bias the diode. It means positive terminal of the battery has to be connected to the cathode and negative terminal of the battery has to be connected to the anode. Now, in that case, what will happen? Let me extend this XY axis. This is Y and this is X. So I have extended the XY axis. Is it? Now apply reverse voltage to the diode and start increasing this reverse voltage. Is it? As if I start increasing forward voltage, I got those characteristics. At 0.7 diode will start conducting. This 0.7 volt, generally what we refer it as a knee voltage, KNEE. Is it? This knee voltage, or some people call it as a cutoff voltage. Or startup voltage, cut-in voltage of a diode. So many notations are there. If you refer different books, you will find different notations and different terminologies, different names are there. Let us refer it as a knee voltage of a diode. But it is 0.7 if the diode is made up of silicon material. If diode is made up of germanium, then it is 0.3. Is it? The semiconductor material which is used to manufacture and fabricate the diode, if it is germanium, the knee voltage will be 0.3. If it is silicon, the knee voltage will be 0.7. Now, see, this is what forward characteristics. Now, what will happen if I apply reverse voltage to the diode, which is a simple rectifier diode? What will happen? Up to certain level, diode will not conduct, and this after some voltage, I will call it as breakdown voltage. After this breakdown voltage, what will happen? Diode will suddenly start conducting. Is it? A reverse current will start flowing, but at this particular level, I will call it as I dash. Isn't it? At current I dash, it means now the diode is in reverse bias. We are increasing the reverse voltage across the diode, and now diode is having a reverse current through it. Is it? So this reverse current has very small value, because when you increase reverse voltage in large amount, then very small reverse current will flow. That is known. But when you increase reverse voltage up to a certain voltage, that is a breakdown voltage, then what will happen? Diode will break down. It will start conducting in reverse direction. Is it? So technically, it is not good to tell you that diode will start conducting in reverse direction, is it? But some current in reverse direction flows, but that current will reach up to this value, I dash. That's what it is. If you further increase this reverse voltage, obviously diode will get damage. This one, diode will definitely will get damage. So diode will get damage at a certain current. That current is I dash. Right. So it means diode can handle the maximum reverse current, which is equals to I dash. So what is that I dash then? It is a limit of a diode. Is it? This is what maximum reverse current that diode can handle. That diode can handle. That's what it is, I dash. So if current increases beyond I dash, diode will get damage. Increase reverse voltage of a diode up to VB, that is up to breakdown voltage, there is no current. After breakdown voltage, there is some current in reverse direction, but that current will be very small, because further you increase the voltage beyond breakdown voltage, the diode will reach up to I dash, that is maximum reverse current, and then after that current, diode will get damage. This is what restriction of a rectifier diode in reverse direction, or is what I can say, in a reverse bias condition. So you cannot use this diode, a rectifier diode, in reverse bias, because see, in reverse bias it is not useful for us at all. In reverse bias, very small current flows, the diode cannot handle large current, the voltage, which is breakdown voltage, is, even if it is in some amount, it will sustain for very small time. So a rectifier diode is useful only in forward bias. In reverse bias, I don't find any use of that diode. Is it? So that's why then what people started with? Is it? People started adding impurities in a simple diode. Look at this. It means this diode, which is a rectifier diode, if I add some impurities into that, let me add some impurities, trivalent or pentavalent. Then by adding some impurities in a rectifier diode, the properties of that rectifier diode will get changed. The parameters, the properties will get changed. And that changed properties will find a new diode, is it? Then that new impurity added diode is your Zener diode. Look at this. A simple diode, a simple rectifier diode, add some impurities, it becomes a Zener diode. Is it? Now, why I am adding some impurities, or what will be the effect of adding some impurities in the simple rectifier diode? Is it? We will observe the effect also, and that effect is useful, and that's why I am using this Zener diode in a regulator circuit. Right. So, conclusively, rectifier diode is there. Forward characteristics are useful, but in reverse bias, it is not useful. Then, what people started with, they added some impurities, trivalent and pentavalent impurities are added into a simple rectifier diode. Then it becomes a new version of a simple rectifier diode. Is it? That new version is given a separate name, that is Zener diode. Look at this. What is that Zener diode? It is a new version of rectifier diode, and what they have done, they added some impurities into that. So add some impurities in that, you will find a Zener diode. Now let us check what is the properties Zener diode is offering now. As I have added some impurities, it means the characteristics has to be different. Let me draw the characteristics of a diode then. Is it? Characteristics of a new diode, that is Zener diode. Okay, let me add a page here. Look at this, a diode. What I will do, I will draw forward as well as reverse characteristics of a diode. I'm just trying to draw a straight line because I want to draw the XY axis, is it not? So this is what Y axis. Let me draw Y axis first, and then I will draw X axis. This is what my X axis. Now, as we are in the VI characteristics, so voltage is there on X axis and current is there on Y axis. Right. Now look at this, a diode characteristics. A simple diode, simple rectifier diode with some added impurities becomes a Zener diode. Is it? Now this Zener diode, if I make it forward bias, then what will happen? In forward bias, it shows same characteristics as that of rectifier diode, is it not? If you connect a rectifier diode in forward direction or in forward bias, then you will find that in forward bias it will show same characteristics as that of rectifier diode. Look at this. This is Zener diode, which is equals to rectifier diode. So there is no change in the forward characteristics. Forward characteristics of Zener diode is same as forward characteristics of a rectifier diode. Now, what's the use of adding some impurities and having a new kind of diode, a new type of diode, that is Zener diode? Why we are doing this? Yes, there is a difference in reverse direction. Look at this. When I reverse bias this Zener diode, look at this. Now, let me reverse bias this Zener diode. Reverse bias means what? Negative has to be connected to the anode and positive has to be connected to the cathode. In this scenario, if I increase this reverse voltage, then what will happen? Diode will not conduct until its breakdown voltage. Look at this. At a breakdown voltage, look at this, at VB, at breakdown voltage, a reverse current will start flowing through the diode. Is it? Now, what happened with the rectifier diode in reverse bias? At a particular point, at a particular current, diode was get damaged. Is it? When it was a rectifier diode. But now what is happening in reverse direction, in reverse biasing of a Zener diode, the current is increasing. Look at this. Even if you increase this reverse voltage, current will start increasing. You further increase this voltage, current will start further increasing. Look at this. Current is not stopping. It is still increasing. It means now what I can conclude from this graph, look at this. Current is increasing in reverse direction. And the voltage across the diode is still constant. Look at this, voltage across the diode. This is voltage. on y sorry on x axis, look at this, it is still constant. But what about the current? Current is still increasing. So it gives increased current with constant voltage. Look at this, I will write here, it is a constant voltage with increased current. With increased current, what does it mean? It means that Zener can handle, look at this, Zener can handle more current in reverse direction. Reverse direction, or you can write Zener can handle more current in a reverse bias. So that is the best and biggest important property of a Zener diode, that Zener diode can handle more current in a reverse direction. It will not get damaged for a short current, is it? The ability of a Zener diode to handle large current in reverse direction, that is what its best or nice property related to that Zener diode. And what about the voltage? Voltage is still constant. Look at this, everywhere voltage is constant. So it means in reverse bias, Zener gives constant voltage and large current. What about the forward bias? In forward bias, it gives same characteristics as that of rectifier diode. But the characteristics of Zener are different in reverse direction. So let me write it here as in reverse bias. Look at this, in reverse bias, Zener gives constant voltage and large current. That's what it is. I will get it as number one and number two. So in reverse bias, Zener gives constant voltage and large current. So those are the best parameters offered by the Zener diode, and that's why this Zener is mostly used in regulators. Because see, what we want in regulator, we want constant output voltage. Constant voltage, that's what our need is, our demand, our requirement is that constant voltage. So if Zener is giving constant voltage in reverse bias, then obviously Zener is the useful component for us. So it means if I have a rectifier, look at this, I have a rectifier plus filter circuit, and if I apply this output of rectifier plus filter circuit to a Zener diode, look at this, to a Zener diode which is in reverse bias, then obviously across the Zener I will get constant voltage. That's what it is. Just connect a simple Zener diode in reverse bias. Look at the Zener is in reverse bias, because in reverse bias only it can give us constant voltage. That is the only reason Zener is generally, or all the time, it is used in reverse bias. Because if I want to use it in forward bias, why to go for Zener? I have rectifier diodes. It offers same characteristics and properties in forward bias, is it? So generally, at the time of Viva, people ask the question, why Zener is always used in reverse bias? So you should be able to answer that Zener is used in reverse bias all the time, because only in reverse bias it gives constant voltage and it gives large current. The current handling capacity in reverse bias is more if I compare them with forward biasing. Now see, I have a block diagram of rectifier, filter as well as regulator. Now instead, if I draw a small circuit just for a reference, then let me draw the small circuit, that I will draw a Zener. Look at this, there is a Zener which is in parallel with the output voltage that I am getting from rectifier as well as filters. So let me write it here, this is output from rectifier plus filter. So whatever output you are getting from rectifier and filter, you connect that output as an input to the Zener diode. And here somewhere across the Zener, let me connect a small resistor. I will call it as load resistor. So measure output voltage across this resistor, that will be a constant when Zener is in reverse bias. Simple. This circuit is called Zener shunt regulator. Look at this. Even in the discussion itself, I have drawn Zener shunt regulator circuit. Now, it is called shunt regulator because the main active element is what? Zener. So, Zener is the active element. And this active element is in shunt with the load resistor. Look at this. Zener is in parallel, or it is in shunt with the load resistor. And that's why it is called shunt regulator. Instead of Zener, if I connected a transistor, if I connect a transistor which is in parallel with the load, then the circuit becomes transistor shunt regulator. Is it? Any active element from your circuit, if it is in shunt with the load, it is shunt regulator. If it is in series with the load, it becomes a series voltage regulator. Is it? So that's why you remember that we had two types of regulators. First type is series voltage regulator and second one is shunt voltage regulator. We started with shunt voltage regulator. Shunt means in parallel. So any active element, maybe it is a Zener or a transistor, if it is in shunt with the load, it is a shunt regulator. Or the active element, transistor or maybe a Zener, if it is in series with the load, then it is a series voltage regulator. Is it? So we started with the Zener, we understood the Zener theory, and finally we are concluding with Zener shunt regulator. Look at this. Zener shunt regulator was the final conclusion. Now, in next lecture, what we'll do? In next lecture, we will start with the Zener shunt regulator circuitry. We will understand the operation. Is it? We'll understand the operation. Plus, we will analyze the circuit. Is it? And if possible, we will start with design of circuitry. Right? So wait for next lecture. Next lecture, we will start with the Zener shunt regulator. Meanwhile, if possible, try to read about Zener diode. Is it? In short, I have given a description, the characteristics about what is Zener. The construction is same as that of rectifier diode. Is it? Just few impurities are added. Now, adding impurities is not your concern for the time being. I'm just telling you the process. The small signal diode, or I can say a rectifier diode, is converted into Zener diode. Add some impurity, it becomes a Zener, which is useful in reverse bias. Is it? So, we'll again, we'll meet in next lecture with Zener shunt regulator.